Hello students, so welcome back to the channel. In this video we are going to study about the polygenic inheritance. See, before we start this topic, first of all try to understand what was according to the Mendel. According to Mendel, it was ki for one character there is one gene. Okay, for one character there is one gene, because he was saying characters are controlled by factor. Factors are nothing, genes. This was Mendel concept. But later on, after the Mendel era was over, means in the post-Mendel era, the scientist observed that sometimes, means after Mendel, I'm writing it this way, please try to understand. It is observed that one character can be controlled by many genes. It can be controlled by many genes. And as a result, we will say it is polygene concept. So it is polygenic inheritance. For example, we can take human skin color. Human skin color is the one which is controlled by three genes. Character is one, okay? Character is one, which one character? Only skin color. But human skin color is controlled by three genes. So let me first explain you how the people got an idea, okay? See beta, these were the scientists, Nielsen and East. They were working on two examples are there. Kernel color in wheat, kernel color in wheat, and length of corolla in tobacco. The corolla length in tobacco. And they found that ki these characters are controlled by polygene. And especially when they were working on this one, kernel color in wheat, when they were working, they observed that when a red is crossed with white, when red grain was crossed with white grain, is it clear? Then F1 was red, but it was in intermediate only. Your F1 generation was red, but it was intermediate. Neither pure red, neither pure white, neither it is giving pink also. Okay, it is not giving pink. But when this F1 was selfed, then they observed that they are finding five different phenotypes. And F2 generation was showing 1/16 as extreme red color, extreme red. 4/16 were deep red, shades of red only, but they are not proper red, they are different shades are coming. 6/16 was intermediate red. 4/16 were light red. And only 1/16 was white. So they got total 15 red. Check carefully, they got 15 red in this. All these are red only, but there are shades of red. So from this, they got an idea. It means character is not controlled by one gene. It might be controlled by many genes. And kernel color in wheat, this example, please focus carefully. This example is the one which is controlled by the two genes. The character for it is controlled by two genes. Is it clear? So when it is controlled by two genes, your ratio is coming 1:4:6:4:1. Is it clear? And now we are going to study human skin color, and we have to see what phenotype ratio we will get in F2 generation. Now see one thing, human skin color, you know very well, it is because of melanin pigment. Okay, melanin pigment is responsible for our skin color, and it is controlled by three genes. And three genes, each gene is having only two alleles. So we are using this symbol. This is one gene with two alleles, another gene with two alleles, and this one with two alleles. So it is controlled by three genes. Right now I have written all dominant. These genes will be present at different loci. Okay, genes are present at different loci. And each dominant gene is responsible for making melanin. So this word is important. It is a dominant gene which is responsible for contributing for the skin color. Dominant gene is responsible for making the melanin pigment. So as a result, we will say more and more dominant means more and more melanin pigment. So we can say the dominant gene shows, okay, dominant gene will show additive effect. Dominant gene will show cumulative effect. We will say either additive effect or we will say cumulative effect. I hope you are able to understand my language. And please focus, I am writing dominant gene, not recessive. More and more dominant alleles are coming means more and more effect will be there. Is it clear? And this study was done by Davenport, and he has done it. Human skin color is controlled by three genes. Okay, they are controlled by three pair of genes. Each gene is having two alleles. So now let me explain you the cross. Now see here, I'm taking a cross between this all six capital means this person is very dark. And with no capital means this very light. Let us assume this is male. This male is getting married to the female who is very light. Then their children will be intermediate type. Children will neither be very dark, neither they will be very light. Children will be intermediate type of phenotype, and this intermediate phenotype is known as mulatto. Is it clear? Now, when you do the selfing, means if you see marriage between two mulattoes, if marriage occurs between two mulattoes, then what will be the phenotype ratio? So first of all, you know how to make the gametes. If you see, this will make the gametes. Let us make, we will separate the two alleles. Then again, we will separate. See the diagram carefully, okay? See the board carefully, then only you will be able to understand the concept. This already I have explained in the previous video, but again, I'm drawing it so that you can understand the concept. If you want, you can check the video of the gamete formation. So this is the way how gamete formation will be done, and this is known as fork line method. So fork line method is one which we use for the gamete formation. It is easy for understanding. So these are the eight types of the gametes. If suppose it is made by the male parent, then same type of the gametes will be made by the female parent or not. So these are the eight types of gametes which are made. So now we will do the Punnett square, okay? We will put these gametes on the Punnett square. Now see, beta, this is the one you will get the Punnett square, okay? See here, you can see the board carefully. These are the male gametes, okay? Eight types of the male gametes here. 6, 8, 7, 8, okay? And same eight types of the female gametes here. Now, when you are writing it, you are getting 64 Punnett boxes. And now you have to check the ratio. Check carefully. You are getting one very dark, six dark, 15 fairly dark, 20 are intermediate, 15 fairly light, six light, and one very light. Okay, so your ratio is coming 1:6:15:20:15:6:1. Let me write it here for you. So your ratio is coming 1:6:15:20:15:6:1. This is the ratio you are getting. Now let me explain you the trick how to solve such questions. See beta, whenever you have to find the ratios, na, what will be the phenotype ratio of when the character is controlled by 2 gene or 3 gene? One trick is there. You do one thing, just write first 1:2:1. Just write this first. And then you keep one here and add these two. I think so your total will be 3. Check what am I doing here. Then it will be 3 and 1 at the end. Okay. Again, keep 1 at the end and add these two. 4:6:4:1. Again, do this. 1:5:10:10:5:1. Clear beta? One more time. Just one more time. Last time. 6:15:20:15:6:1. Now see one trick. This you just remember, this is your genotype ratio of monohybrid cross you have written. Okay. Then skip one line and share. This is the one which you get the ratio when the character is controlled by 2 genes. And this you will get when the character is controlled by 3 genes. Is it clear? This is when the character is controlled by 2 genes, and this you will get when the character is controlled by 3 genes. Understood? I think so. If you remember, when I was telling you kernel color in wheat, F2 generation ratio was 1:4:6:4:1. And right now for our skin color, we have studied 1:6:15:20:15:6:1. So I hope this much topic is clear to you how to get it. If they ask you for 4 genes, again to make this way, skip one line and again you will get the phenotype ratio. Okay. Now, which one is very dark? Which one is dark? Again, let me give you one more trick. Now see one more trick. If you remember right now, the ratio was 1:6:15:20:15:6:1. Then what is the phenotype? Phenotype was right here, VD. VD means very dark. Then write here D. D means dark. Then write FD. FD means fairly dark. Write M. M means mulatto. And now you have to just see in reverse only. Okay, you have to now do the reverse. Here it will be FL, means fairly light. Then you write L, means light. And you write VL, means very light. Now how will you find which one is what? You have to just see how many number of capitals are there, okay? Number of capitals you have to just count. You don't need to do anything. Suppose here, if here this will come when all 6 are capitals. All 6 capitals are there. This you will get when 5 capitals are there. This you will get when only 4 capitals are there. And this when 3 capitals. This when you have 2 capitals. And this when only 1 capital. And when no capital, then your color will be very light. Let me give you one question idea so that you can apply it and you can learn it also. Okay, just give me 1 minute. Let me give you the question idea. See here, this is your one question. Suppose I am saying ki this person is getting married to this lady. So first of all, you know ki it will make how many types of gametes? You know very well ki it is heterozygous for only one conditions. So it will make only 2 types of gametes. Okay, this will separate. This will go for fork line. Capital B, small b. okay, and then you have to solve it. A capital B, A small b, and here only small c, okay, and it will make only one type of gamete, that is a small a, small b, small c. So this is the gamete from here, and this is the gamete made by the male. Now you do one thing, make a Punnett box. Just make the Punnett box for it, and now you apply it. You don't need to solve it, you have to just check how many capitals are there. If you see, mother cannot give any capital, it is always coming only from the father's side. So for this, if suppose this is sperm, then it will be two capitals will be with the child, and with this only one capital with the child. And if suppose two capital means you have to search which one, this area number two capitals. So what will be the phenotype? The child will be fairly light. So you will write here, okay, the child will be FL. FL means fairly light. And with only one capital, what will you say? Your child will be light. So you will write here L. L means light. So you can, if suppose the answer is asked in whatever presentation, so you can say, ki one will be out of two will be fairly light, and one out of two will be only light. Is it clear? Copy this, and again I will give you one more question so that you can solve it. See, let me give you one more question. Suppose this is one. It is getting married to this. So you know very well it will make eight types of gametes. So let us first make the gametes only. First of all, we have to make the gametes. That is why one video I have already made for the gamete formation. Please check it if you are not able to understand. You can ask me also. You can message me and ask me. And this will make only one type of gamete. This one. Now you do one thing, make Punnett square. Make the Punnett box. Okay. And you don't write the genotype unnecessary. Don't waste your time, because in the exam that will be problem if you write it. So better do the smart work. And now you just count how many capitals. See, this parent will not give you any capital. Only capital will come from this parent's side only. So here three capital, two capitals, two capital, one capital, two capital, one capital, one capital, and no capital. I hope you are able to understand. Three capital means these three, two capital means these two, this two capital means this capital A, capital C, one capital only capital A, two capital means BC, only B, only C, and no capital. Now you know very well, when three capitals are there, it means it is M. Okay. Two capitals means it is fairly light, fairly light, it is light, fairly light, 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 very light. So if suppose they ask you a question, how many light children will be there? So you will say light children will be total three out of eight. How many fairly light will be there? Fairly light, you will give the answer, it will be again three out of eight. Mulatto will be only one out of eight, and very light child will be also only one out of eight. So I hope this trick will help you to solve the questions of the polygenic inheritance. Now, if you see in this question, which we discussed right now, only we are giving importance to how many number of capitals are there. Which capital we are not giving importance? We are giving importance to only the number of capital. That is why polygenic inheritance is also known as, it is also known as quantitative inheritance, because we are giving importance to quantity. So it is also known as quantitative inheritance. Is it clear? We are applying the polygene in the plants also. Let me give you one idea for the plant question also. Now plants, the question will be given ki height is controlled by 3 gene, okay, and they are saying maximum height is 24 cm and minimum height is 6 cm. So maximum height means all capital, so it means all capital means this condition which is 24 cm, it means one allele, one gene, okay, one gene, not pair, I'm not saying pair, one gene. So it means 24/6. So each is contributing 4 cm. Understood? Now minimum height means all recessive. So all recessive means this condition. And they are saying minimum is 6 cm. So it means 6/6. So it means one centimeter, each one is contributing. Now my question is, tell me the height of this plant. What is the height of this plant? How will you solve? You have understood all capitals means each capital is giving 3 cm and each recessive is giving 1 cm contribution here. So what will you say? This is 4 cm, this is 1 cm, 1, 1, 4, 1, and you have to just add and then you will get the answer. And your answer will be, I think so, 4 + 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So you will say 12 centimeter height will be the plant height. I hope this practice as well as explanation is clear to you. Still, if you are having doubt, then you can ask me. Thanks for watching.